First of all, you need a circuit. I make it and look at it. And then draw it. Here we have an OR gate and then an inverter, input and output. If you have it and tested it, then you need a schematic. In this case, it's a binary to BCD converter. With two power inputs, four logic inputs and four logic outputs. Then, and here we can see the base resistor, 27k's and 47k. And my SMD transistor. And that's an inverter. Okay. And here we have an OR gate with four inputs. And here we have an OR gate with five inputs. And an OR gate with two inputs. Yeah. And then if you have the schematics, you need to draw the board itself. I begin here with the transistor, the base resistor and the other resistor. The other resistor is connected to the power, so it needs there at a 5V up to there. 2 hours of routing, it looks like this. And here we can see my newest project, that's a rotary decoder with 24 outputs, and you will see it later what it does. In my case, I used two layers, just the top and bottom layer. It makes it easier, and in this case it doesn't matter, because I will print it all in black and white and filled, and don't mind this factor. Yeah, and print it out with a laser printer, and then it's ready for the transfer method.
You print it out and then cut it out, and yeah, then cut out a piece of copper plated hard paper, maybe a bit bigger than your layout. You can use hard paper with one-sided or hard paper with two-sided plated copper, or that's a bit thinner. And that's, fiberglass. Yeah. And then, if you can see it, I used a steel wool, but make it really, really gentle, because otherwise it looks like this. If the scratch is too big, the plastic from the toner lays on top of there, and the etching fluid will move underneath it, and the problem is it when you have very thin tracks, you will get a disconnection after etching. Yeah, and then take some kind of paper, in my case it's toilet paper, and some acetone. And remove the grease and the oil and fat maybe from your fingers, and some dust from the steel wool. And that's it. Cut it up and take a bit. That's nice cold on the fingers. A bit harder, a bit more pressure. Yeah, and that looks shiny. So, then close the acetone again. Maybe you should open a window if you make it inside. And yeah, after washing it with water and after the water island test, it's ready. Just lay it on top of there. Look if it's nice placed. In my case, It is. Yeah, that must be fine. And then don't move it around and put it through a tuned laminator. Feel it. It's hot, yeah. Then. And then slow it down a bit. It's not hot enough. Some guys, I put the board itself a few times through, then it sticks on the board, and yeah, and you can use the steel wool, or some others etch it a bit. No, but it works very fine. And then put it a second time. I hope it sticks now. Yeah, and then do it a few times. Yeah, and then if it's done, gently pull it off. In my case, there are a few holes, but this doesn't matter, and you can just put it there, so then there's a copper, and your etching solution has a longer duration of life. Yeah, just make a fool of it. But yeah, if you want to make it again, you can print it out again and remove this all with acetone, and it works well. Yeah, then here a bit. That's the first step. And then the other holes, if you can see it. So yeah, and when it's done, it looks like this. And then we can etch. In my case, it's behind there. Yeah. I have some air thing for fish. And a fish heater. Fish water heater. It's a bit overpowered, because now it makes about 40 degrees, maybe 45. Yeah, and the air bubbler for the nice movement of the solution, and then it works just faster. Yeah, and then put it in.
So now, and let's wait. And maybe you wash your fingers when you touch it, because hot sulfuric acid isn't funny. Yeah, and now we wait about 15 minutes, or maybe 10 minutes.
So it's done. I drilled a hole inside. And as you can see, there was the stripe from the holding. And yeah, and now remove the toner. Take some toilet paper or something. And then don't use this side, because you will push the plastic inside the board. Okay, that's done. I saw a mistake. Let's test it. This one must be there. The last one, yeah. Yeah, and now, before you touch it too much, a little bit steel wool. Yeah, take some hot water. Yeah, and then you put it in and wait a second. Yeah, and now it works. Old and cold. And so it needs a bit more. Let's look at it. You can see the tin film on it. It's not nice. Smash it a bit. Look at it. Yeah, it looks okay. And that's it. Now you have to cut it on the edges, and then you place the parts on it and solder it. And good luck for your PCBs. See you later.